The future of space tourism is when, for most people, it's a lifestyle decision to go to the edge of space and see the world that they live in. I think it would be a tremendous shame to live my entire life on a planet I've never really seen. I think that sort of changes how you view life and really gives you a better appreciation.
We're working to make space as accessible as a commercial airline flight. We have people from all around the world who bought tickets to fly in the WorldView capsule. Our tickets right now are $75,000 a seat. The oldest person is in their 80s. So it's truly an accessible and exciting trip for people.
Air Force balloonist Captain Joseph Kittinger Jr. is laced into an elaborate pressure suit in preparation for a daring ascent into the stratosphere.
The idea for balloons and manned space goes all the way back to Kittinger in the 50s. Before the age of rockets and the great space race, we were using high altitude balloons to take people to the edge of space. And so it's this really old idea that's laid dormant really for the last 60 years, and it seemed it was time to bring it back. As we began to develop that project, the StratX program came along. The team really gelled around taking Alan Eustace to the edge of space and having him jump from the edge of space down very quickly. The team and that technology essentially formed the basis of WorldView.
The balloon that takes the capsule up is about the size of a football stadium. So imagine looking out the window when it's completely dark out and there's an incredible starscape outside, like really nobody has seen except the astronauts. And you'll see the sun start lighting up the planet below you. You'll see the curvature of the Earth, but the sky will still be black. It's going to be the most extraordinary sight.
When it's time to come back, we open up a big parafoil that is about 3,200 square feet, the largest parafoil that's ever been operated. This parafoil, for example, is about 1,200 square feet, so it'd be about three times bigger than this one. The balloon itself falls essentially in a big ball of plastic towards the Earth, but then a team goes out and collects the balloon, and it gets turned into plastic bottles.
We really feel that taking people up in this way is going to really open the door to a space experience in a way that you really can't do any other way. Humans have always explored. We've always gone beyond. We always have. And we always must. That's what, in large measure, makes us human.